By the end of this video, you know how to create a landing page using a no-code tool, which means no coding, and be able to link it to your email service provider and publish it using your domain name or a subdomain. We'll look at the design, we'll look at colors, fonts, and how to use AI to help us in this process. So let's get straight into it. Now, the landing page we're going to build today is a tech newsletter. So think about a newsletter that goes out daily or weekly that talks about the latest news in tech. Now, we're going to build the landing page using Card. And instead of going to landing is more like a little mini website or like a single page website. So you do have some forms here, but if we just click on one as a demo, you'll see that it's going to be a little bit more just lots of information, browsing, that type of thing. It's hard to know what this one is actually for. But then if we go back and we go to forms, this is where people are going to be able to enter their email address. You can build those types of landing pages. So I built a coming soon page on this channel recently. Check that out. There'll be a link in the description. But for this project, what we're doing is an email newsletter about new tech products. So if we select this one here, it says Try Pro. Watch our full review on this because we go through the benefits of Pro in a nutshell, $19 a year, and you get the custom domains, the forms, widgets, etc. But we can always do a free trial. Select and start Pro trial. So you've got 7 days to do this. And then what you do is then you come onto this page here. Now, if you take a little look down here below, you can see there's that little hashtag done with thank you. So when it comes to landing pages, a lot of the time you're also designing the thank you page. Now, I have used thank you pages with my multiple websites in the past to allow people to take further action. So let's say it is this idea that we have where you're sending a newsletter about tech updates, about the latest gadgets, then you might want to link to your YouTube channel here because people are in the process of interacting with you and you want them to continue interacting with you. Or if you have a course, you might say, hey, why not join our course or our premium program, those types of things. But this is the slate that we have, where it's very simple. You have the logo image up here. You have a title, text, sign-up form. That's it. Now, you might want to look into privacy policies, those types of things put down here. That's out of the scope of this video. But the first thing we want to do is to change this image. Now, I'm just going to nip over. And you're going to come with me to Canva. Now, this is something I just used as like the design logo, found one of the logos, changed it to Tech Internet just to mix it up a little bit. But the reason I've done this over here on Canva is because, one, it's simple to do, but also what we can do is choose this color here and then remember this. It's FD2525. Also, we can copy and paste it. And then what I like to do is come over to ChatGPT and say, what's a good color gradient color to go with this one. Okay, and it's going to give us some color gradients here. So this is a bold red, could be this one, a warm orange tone. I'm just going to let this run a little bit. So it says here, warm orange or yellow adds energy, while darker reds or magentas offer depth. Let's go for depth. So we're going to take this color here, okay, go back over to Card. Because our starting point is the background. So we have this as a gradient and this as a gradient. So we're going to go with the magna color over here. And then I'm going to just try something a little bit different. Go to the yellow and use that as our starting point over here. Looking good. Now, the next thing we can do is just to upload the image. So if we click this element here, and Card is just drag and drop, click on the elements, and you get the menu over here to change. I'm going to upload that image. Here's our logo. It's not fitting perfectly, so we can just expand it like this and hopefully keep it centered or make it look somewhat centered. And there we go. So we've got the red up here. We've got this over here. Now I'm going to go back over to ChatGPT and ask for some colors for sign-up buttons. So I said, what about a sign-up button color based on our logo red color? Let's have a look. Same red. Oh, you can keep it the same red. And then white. A lighter red for the hover effect. So what I like to do is just go with what it says and overthink things too much. And with the form, what we have is we can go to fields, we can go to button. So we've got the button here, it's sign up. And then we go to appearance, click button, and then we've got the solid style. And what we're going to do is change it to the red. Okay. So we are currently using a gradient. I'm just going to get rid of that gradient. Now that looks a little bit harsh at the moment, probably because the color isn't white. So what we're going to do is just drag this, if we can, to white. Okay, so we've got that. Sign up. I'm just going to play around with the fonts a little bit and pause the video while I do it. Okay, so just played around with the button a little bit. To do that, you need to go into the appearance here. And also, what you need to do is look at the button form here. So it says on-click default. If you want to do payment gateways, then you can do it required payment, for example. But for this purpose, all we're doing is having someone enter their email address. I actually changed it back to the font here to make it more techy. Okay, so the next thing we need to do is enter text here. Now, what I recommend is looking at some of your favorite email newsletters and seeing what kind of titles they use in order to get people to opt in, because a title is such an important thing. The main thing is that we get across the benefits of what's going to happen. So we want to have benefits in here. And if I'm just going to just think about it on the spot, I'll go over here and say something like, and try and make it fun in a way, but opt in to stay to be the smartest person in the room about tech. Now, it's not perfect, and this has become a title that people are using recently, but something like that, where you're trying to get people's attention. Now, I quite like how big this is here, and that we're not really focusing on pictures, we're not really focusing on other things. Instead, we're just using this kind of font, which looks like it's a tech type of font with a strong title. And then here, it's always good with social proof. So join X other people who get the latest and greatest, that's not perfect, but we'll go with it, news about tech, gadgets, etc. So that, and then add in another benefit here. The trend at the moment is to use more casual language when it comes to landing pages, when it comes to adverts, etc. So just put your personality into this, or the brand personality into this too. I actually think these icons are a waste on this page, the landing page, because you don't want the landing page to be about browsing. You want people just to say, okay, this is what I'm going to do. It's either I'm entering my email address or not. You don't want them to go, oh, I'll just check their Instagram, because then you're losing that lead. So instead, what you can do is just drag it down to, hopefully this works, drag it down to here. So it's on the thank you page, or just delete them. Now, let's say you like this in terms of how it looks on desktop, but on mobile, you're like, oh, I don't want that to be so big. Well, what you can do is click on an icon here. You can go to the style setting here, the appearance, go down, and at the bottom, it says mobile, click manual, and then it's on auto at the moment, but we can even change the line spacing where it's more like that. The size, you might just have to play around with it first, but around there, that works. So then what's happening, and you can test this once the site's live and go on your mobile phone too, but the key point here is that this email address and sign up button is above the fold. It's above the place where they have to scroll down and do something. So you want to have it fit on all one screen. Other ways to do this is to change the padding around here. You can decrease the logo size. You can take away the logo. You can make this double in terms of a column here and a column here, which isn't smart for mobile. But just there are lots of options here when it comes to trying to bring this up to where it should be. So now let's say we like this design. There's one more thing I want to mention. With the background, we can do certain things. So there are all these different types of patterns that you can introduce into the background. Now this one that we're using is animated. So it's an animated background, but there are just so many different things here that you can use. And we might just want to find one that kind of gives the idea of tech. For example, that's more party. It doesn't really feel like it's tech. This is great for like a podcast, for example. So is this one. And there might not be one that you like. So for example, we might try this one. It's okay. You can make the size bigger. So it's more like that. I actually quite like that. in terms of just finding one very quickly. You can change the thickness of this, which is terrible there. But if you take it down to 2 or 3, that's probably what I like the best. And then click done. Okay, so let's say now we like this landing page. Obviously, it's not perfect. You might want to play around with it a little bit. There are two things to do now. First, we click over here, and this is bringing up the form element. And what we need to do is click this one here, and then we can see we can start to set up this form, because you're going to have to connect this form to your email service provider. So we have over here, ActiveCampaign, Beehive, ConvertKit. These are the ones I've heard of. GetResponse, HubSpot, MailChimp, MailerLite, SendFox, Sendy. Let's just say that you're going to use ActiveCampaign, okay? With ActiveCampaign, what we can do is set this up through ActiveCampaign using this here. And instead of going through this, what I'm going to do is to leave a link here. And you can see it has instructions for all of these different email service providers. So what we have is you can just go through this and just enter the correct details in here so that you can connect ActiveCampaign and Card. So that when somebody clicks on this email address, clicks sign up, it's going to automatically add their email address to ActiveCampaign. And I like over here, it says, can't highlight it, but hopefully you can read this, captures emails to ActiveCampaign contacts, optionally adding them to a list of automation. So what you can do is add them to a list, you can tag them and add them automatically to an automation using this form here. Then from there, you can send out your emails weekly, daily, whenever it may be, to people who have entered their email address on this form. So let's say that you've done that. The next stage is to click up here and this button over here, which says publish. So it is time to publish. So you'll need an account to do this. And we've got two options here. Publish to a card.co URL, or once you have signed up and paid, you can publish to a custom domain, which is your domain. For example, techintimate.com, that might be taken. But this allows you to publish to that. Now, if you have a website where you are building a full website about things, for example, you have a blog, you have a landing page, you have a homepage, sorry, you have courses, etc. Then what you might want to do is create a new custom domain where it's techintimatenewsletter.com. Or you might just want to keep this card.co URL. But whenever, this is a really key point, whenever you link to this website, let's say on Facebook, on Twitter, on LinkedIn, what you can do is use techintimatenewsletter.com and redirect that to this card URL. But in most cases, what you want to do is publish this to a custom domain name. And then once it's published, go on your desktop, go on your mobile phone, on an iPad, and test it out to make sure it's working okay. Enter your email address, click the sign up button, make sure that you're getting that welcome email that you've set up through ActiveCampaign. Now, be sure to check out our other videos that we've made about using Card. I'll leave a link in the description to that playlist. And then if you want to learn how to build with no code tools, how to build automations, websites, apps, including AI apps, and how to code with AI, then go to nocode.mba and browse our premium courses from the top no code instructors. Thanks again for watching, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye for now.